नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन। So we are discussing shloka number 47 of chapter 2 of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. If you haven't already watched the previous episode, kindly do so because this is a continuation. This is part 2 about shloka number 47. So in the previous video, we discussed about there seems to be some counterintuitive statements in the shloka that Krishna has kept in front of us. But if we clearly understand what Krishna is trying to convey, there is absolutely no room for doubt. There is a lot of clarity that will emerge. In fact, Krishna has hidden the entire essence of Karma Yoga in this shloka. Karma, activity, is such an integral part of our life. Sleeping, eating, taking bath, cooking, you know, grocery shopping, vacations, going to the office, raising children, so many things. Day in and day out, our entire life is filled with activities. These activities can either bind us to this material world, or the same activities, if we know the trick, if we know the formula, the very same activities can actually liberate us from this material world and go back to the spiritual world. The problem is not with karma. The problem is actually with our attachment to the karma and karma phala. So that is why Krishna is not telling you don't do activities, renounce everything, go to the forest and sit and meditate. No, he's not proposing that at all. If anybody says that I've become a spiritualist, that is why I've renounced my family, my work, my children, my everything, and I'm going, he's simply an escapist. He's using Shastra as a lame excuse. He's really not understood Shastra. Because as you clearly said, Krishna is telling Arjuna, you have to perform your duty, prescribed duty. But the crux of the whole thing is, ma phaleshu kadachana, without attachment for the results of the activities. So it is not the activity that binds us to the material world, it is our attachment to the fruits of the activities that we perform that actually binds us to this material world. Not just activities, even with people. Your spouse is not the problem. Your attachment to your spouse is the problem. Your children are not the problem. Your attachment to your children is the problem. Like for example, if your neighbor's kid gets first rank, how happy and jubilant will you feel? Not much. Perhaps some people will feel envious also. But the same thing, if your own son or daughter comes first in the class, first rank holder, how do you feel? You will be thrilled, jumping up and down with joy. The result is the same, getting first rank. But when the neighbor's kid gets, you're not happy. But when your kid gets, you're so happy. Why? Because you're attached to your child. You have that bondage with your child. Maybe somebody said something abusive to you, but if it's a stranger on the street, you don't even give, 2 cents towards it. You just ignore it. But if the same thing somebody from your own family, near and dear one says, it hurts you so deeply because the problem is you're attached to them. So that person is not the problem, that abusive word is not the problem, but the attachment that you have towards that person is the problem. And that is why Krishna is telling, do not have this entitlement. Do not feel that you are the cause of the result and you have to get a certain result. Not necessary. So very profound actually if you contemplate on this. Because every time, almost all the time, our focus is not on the activity itself, but it is at the result that we get from that activity. And Krishna is entirely shifting that focus. He's telling, do not focus on the result. Just focus on your prescribed duty. Just keep on doing it. So, and actually there is more to this shloka. So I want to share quite a bit more. I want to give you the formula for the result of any action. The karma part is just one part of it. There are few more that added together will bring some results. So what is that formula for the phala, for the result? For that, you stay tuned until the next video. I will be right back with you. Please share the video with others as well. If you haven't subscribed to our Aradhana channel, please do so, because it's a daily video series called Grow Through Gita, and we'll be uploading more series. So kindly share with others, and you also watch and enjoy. So I'll be back with the next video. Until then, take care. Hare Krishna.